What's up guys, it's MADSTAR back again, and today we're looking at NIO, and it went up 17.44%, and I thought, why not do a little bit of a technical analysis? Personally, I am holding 100 shares of NIO currently, and if it comes down, I'll down cost average, because the market is pretty volatile right now. The Dow, I believe, ended 20 points up today, and the Nasdaq ended up 4%, around 400 points up. So it was pretty insane today, the market. We don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. We don't know what's going to happen the next month. But in my opinion, NIO in the next few years can easily double, triple, even maybe go 5 times, 10 times. But that's just my opinion. I think China's market is the biggest EV market right now, and there's a lot of growth in the Chinese market. And I think NIO and XPeng, or however you say XPeng and Li Auto, they're going to do great in the Chinese sector. So a little bit of a technical analysis. TradingView does not show the accurate price, because I'm pretty sure I saw NIO go to around 32 2 days ago. And I didn't buy at 32, but it's not showing here. It briefly touched 32 and then came a bit up. But so that's the number one support for NIO in the short term. The stock has gone all the way from $10 to, let's say, $60, $63 up here at a high. But currently, it's at $41, and it's currently above this support level. So it's shown quite a lot of strength right now. And I think it's going to take some time to break this again for NIO. And if it can just stay above 40 for some time and maybe go to this 45 level, that will be really nice for NIO stock. My price target is that in the next 1 year, it will be at least around $60, because this is a pretty massive dip for NIO. I think it's down 33% from its highs. Today was a big recovery, 17%, so I am happy about this, but do mind that if it falls under 40, guys, I cannot stress how weak NIO stock will be, and it's just going to plummet back down to this 32 support, and that's its next support. And I think this support is pretty strong, because it's hard imagining NIO falling under $32 unless there's a big short seller report or anything off that matter. Once again, if it passes above this 41 level, it will be testing this 50 level here, and here's when people start to get bullish about companies. When the EV hype comes, it can pretty much break out up here. Can I draw? I'm going to try to draw. So this is what I think NIO stock will do. So I think it's going to go up, maybe test this. So there's going to be a strong recovery in the Nasdaq, and I think the treasury yields are going to be falling. It's just my opinion, but I think as the market is, things can't always go up. So then I think that it'll kind of come down, you know, and then after testing this 40 level, maybe a little bit down, and then I can't really draw it, but it can shoot up in the next few years. Obviously this is a bit of an dramatic thing. So okay, let's just try draw it one more time. So Command Z, and we're gonna see back this chart I've made a few years later. We're gonna see what happens. So why don't we try draw this again? Let's draw the brush. So it will go up a bit like this and down like this, and then slowly kind of go up here. And it's just a bit of fun drawing what's going to happen. You obviously don't know, but I like doing it for the fun and seeing what's going to happen. Obviously, this is not financial advice, and NIO stock probably won't do this. It's just my odd prediction what it might do. In fact, I don't really even think I should include this in the video. So regardless of my price action for the future, I just think you should be analyzing these technicals on NIO stock and seeing what the potential for NIO is in the long term and in the short term. If you want to trade it in the short term, definitely keep an eye on NIO. If it breaks under 40, be sure that you have a stop loss, because it can really come down to 32. If you have a long-term opinion, you can down cost average down over here. Is a great entry price for NIO. I really don't think it's going to be going under 32 with the massive growth the EV industry is going to be having. But this is a stock market, and the stock market can do anything. Trust me, guys. Like, what you think is going to happen never happens. So always take it for granted that something might go wrong. And this price action is gonna be pretty cool to see and see if it actually happens. If it does rise to the 50s, I would sell some of my shares around the 50. I'm more of a long-term holder on XPeng. I think I made another video about XPeng, and you guys can check it on my previous video. So that's it for this video, and I made a nice smiley face here. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you guys want more technical analysis videos, make sure to hit that smash button on the page down below, I think, and subscribe to the channel. And as always, I will see you next time. Thank you.